just don't run and hide from all of this, cause all my planning, I'm gonna stay within. Why can't you open up and try?
Hello, so as you can see, So I suppose this was a plan that I thought I'd maybe do in about 5 or 6 years' time, once I'd saved a bit more money up and, you know, done a few more things. But the way that things turned out, I got myself a little job here. Considering I've only had it for about 2 weeks, it still doesn't quite feel real, so I keep pinching myself, because I'm hoping this little trusty workhorse will keep me going for a good long while yet. Today is the 1st of April 2021, and it's Saturday. I bought this van literally 2 weeks ago to the day. I've already started doing a little bit of work on it, but I thought I might start taking a couple of videos for bits of tips and advice along the way, but also maybe to see if I can just document it as a little something to look back on in years to come maybe. But the plan is to make this my home, hopefully full time, and already I've learned many things. Already spilled a bit of blood there. So as you can maybe see, I've started putting some sound deadening on. I used Dodo Dead Mat stuff and I didn't realise that it would cut me. So I went to go and smooth it down and I got a nice few cuts all over my hands. So I have now invested in a nice pair of gloves that you might be able to see lurking up there. So my main plans for today, which I've written on the wall, are to Dremel and clean up any bits of rust that I can see, give the floor a really good clean, give the sides a really good clean, see if I can get any loose paint off where it looks like it's rusting, in preparation for putting some kind of anti-rust paint down, like Amorite, something or other. And I also want to remove the final panels that I've got here, and I want to try and take up all the panelling on the inside of the cab and the floor, so I can put some more sound deadening in the cab, because I want to try and make like the noise reduction a bit better. And I also want to suss out where all the wiring goes, because I've been trying to put in a reversing camera, and so I've taken out the actual unit. And it's raining. Lovely. Spent a good long while cleaning. I hope you can see that, because it's taken me all day. What did I do? I started off with the Dremel tool. That lasted about 5 minutes. Then I think my camera died. Then I got on with... I started off with a bit of sandpaper, that's all I could find though, so that got a bit tedious. Then I went for some wire wool, got a bit of a file out occasionally. And then for some of the larger patches, I found this really old knackered sanding machine in the garage, so there were some really quite bad patches, and that really helped. Then I went over with the wire wool again, gave it a really good sweep up, then I washed it down just with a bucket of soapy water. And I have bought some paint. Oh, another little job I'm going to hopefully try and do before I start painting is roll on all the sound deadening material that I put in, because I think it has more of an effect if you really push it in, because I only kind of like handle it. I knew we'd have one somewhere. This, I think, is a roller for when you're wallpapering to make sure that the seams are flat together. I had a look at B&Q and I couldn't find anything, and Screwfix, but I had a sneaky feeling that we had one in the house somewhere, so luckily we have. So I'm going to get on rolling my bits, that sounds a bit strange, the metal bits, and then we'll get on to painting with these other knackered brushes I found, so it all worked out rather nicely.
Say, but you even
now, because this is so old, the plastic is just like cracking and it means that this is falling off all the time. I'm not really sure what I can do about it. Plastic band might solve it. Anything might, but for now I just can't be bothered. So this is what I've bought. It's grey. So it's red or grey. Just kind of fancy grey. So I'll put a coat of this on. I'm gonna try and put a couple on, depending on how it turns out. And then in a lot of the holes, I'm going to get some pot rivets. Put those through to kind of fill in, and they're something that won't rust. And then I'll use another layer of paint over the top that will hopefully kind of seal everything nicely, because there are some holes in there which literally just go straight outside, which I didn't even realise. So this is the pot rivet gun. It comes with a couple of different size nozzles because the pot rivets have a few different sized shanks depending on the size of the rivet that you're putting in. So maybe you can't tell the difference on camera, but they slot into the different size kind of nozzles better depending on which rivet you're using. And then essentially what happens is this central part of the rivet is made out of a harder metal than this collar. So as you pop your rivet into your hole, the rivet gun then pulls on this shank and it makes the collar bulge as it pulls towards it, so you end up with this part of the collar on this face and the bulge on the opposite face. And it is a really handy thing for filling in holes. Normally you use it to join two sheets or something together, like perspex to metal or metal to metal, but it actually is an ideal thing for filling in these holes. Try not to show it. So you can see it's starting to deform the shank of the metal. So it's creating that bulge. And then eventually it pops off and you end up with that on one face and your little bulge on the other. And it kind of sandwiches about, you know, the layer in the middle. So that's what my pot rivets are. So there you go. Also, what I did for some areas of the van, which was just a bit grimy, was I got wire wool and then sandpaper as well, and I just kind of went over the whole area so that it lost its sheen from like some of the areas where it was still like the paint is when you get it new. And it says on some areas if you want it to stick better, just to use a mild abrasive to make the surface a bit more kind of accepting of the new material. So that's what I did. So as you can see, I primed everything yesterday, apart from some of the bits on the doors, but I went and gave those a little touch up this morning, but then had to nip out and shut the doors and realised that probably wasn't the best thing to do. And I had another look at this area. I had a little order that was ready to be picked up from Screwfix. I bought myself a load of like ratchet screw bits, I'm not sure if that's the proper word for them. So I'm very tempted to like take these black panels off, take the back kind of bit of body black panel work off. This is all a real good sand, and I bought some white hammerite paint and I thought I might as well just go over it and make it like a really good smooth professional job and let it dry for the rest of the afternoon, and then it's all done in one go and it'll all look smart rather than kind of being this bitty job that doesn't look naff but it wouldn't look as good as it could do. And if I do it now, then it's just kind of done and I don't have to ever really think about it again. So on this bodywork there's just like four of these screws. They are a size 30 head. I don't know what that means, but they're only made of plastic, so they're not very strong. But I guess the way to hold on is this. Just finished up for the day, and this is my final outcome, which I'm pretty chuffed with. I mean, it's so bright, the camera can't record. Good night. And I have just finished kind of putting much of the flooring in and the insulation underneath. I was going to try and put that in this video, but I decided that I wanted to paint the van first, which I thought was going to be a quick job. Ended up being a much bigger job than I expected, so that's going to go in one of the next couple of videos first. And I needed to do that first because I needed to paint the outside of the sills and seal some of those up, so that I could treat the inside of the sills before I insulated them, before I could then put like my waterproof membrane down on the floor. So it sounds rather complicated, but hopefully I will explain it in a different video. So now I do have a floor that's quite permanent, well, hopefully very permanent, and so I can see, like, you know, all the work that I did before is still there, and hopefully it's, you know, doing a good job because it's still there. And I can't remember what else I was supposed to say in this part of the video, so I wrote it down because I am very forgetful like that. And now I've lost my page. So hopefully, yeah, all of that stuff about my paint job, because I don't know whether or not you can tell, but my van hopefully looks like a cow right now. I mean, maybe not to everyone. Some people just think I made it look black and white, nondescriptly, but I went for a cow. Maybe once I get an udder on there, it'll look a bit better. So yeah, but basically, I want my van to be as space-saving as possible. Like, I went for the L2 version of this, and it's only H2 as well. H3 would have been great, but I couldn't find any L2, H3 vans of either Fiats, Peugeots or Citroens. Because I want to be able to fit it in more parking spaces. So everything in my van is going to try and be as dual-purpose as possible. And I'm going to try and make it as, like, heat saving, energy saving, space efficient as possible. Like, I have been researching how to heat my water system, whether or not to do like kind of circular shower systems. So there's lots that I'm hopefully going to put in this van build that will, at least, you know, putting them out on the internet, I will maybe get some feedback from. But at the same time, I would like to finish it at some point in the future. So I might kind of make a few decisions here and there throughout the rest of my build that maybe aren't in keeping with the ultimate efficiency aims that I have right now, just if I want to get things done a bit sooner. Because, I mean, the main idea of having this van is to go and do things in it and to live in it and go and do adventures with friends and things. So already I haven't done as much work on it as I maybe anticipated at this point, mostly because I've been doing things with my friends, and so I wouldn't ever regret doing that kind of stuff. But yeah, so this is the end of episode one, and hopefully I will see some of you in the next one. Who knows when that'll be? Thank you very much for watching. I'm missing anything.